the Darwin Poems by Emily Ballou. Emma. Years later, Darwin would come to the door of the drawing room to see if the clocks moved any more quickly in there than in his study. She'd look up from the piano, his soft, kind wife, her hands as a girl hand curled by Chopin, and comment that either way, that clock kept good pulse for her music. And stepping in and by the side of a glinting rock, in the windowsill sunlight, behind her, he would be transported back to that day in Australia, when he followed the glint of creek water to its end. How young had he been then, dreaming of Lyell's Principles of Geology, and hoping to write a great work of his own. And though his wife bemoaned his loss of God, he always believed it was more like keys misplaced, at first mistakenly, though over time unreplaced, once he learned that doors left unlocked and coats half buttoned let wayward, useful thoughts, like scarves of wind, slip in. He knew he was not indifferent. What other man, by their sickbed, could mind, for hours in the window, the twining habits of vines, twirling to the left, twirling to the right, and barely finishing his cup of tea, record each spurt and curl so dutifully? He and Em had lived for years in a mutual adaptation, as she entwined around the spine of family. He had never stopped loving her fingers like bolts of light on the piano keys, or the tiny soft brown dots over her top lip. She had thought he hadn't noticed. He who examined closely all things, bent to a leaf or worm, one knee in the dirt, one eye to the glass, magnifying the beauty. Still, she would outlive him. Her music, too. And he would think of that creek, and how all he knew of marriage, of love, was embryonic inside him. How enlarged a glint of light he followed to the end of his life, ducking through the brush and branching of water to find, either way, how flimsy we are inside of this time. Really, how ephemeral.